Hello, I am Mr. DJ Doshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering Works, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. We will be today learning about projection of solids. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the projections of solid as per given conditions. Up till now, we have studied projection of solids related to simple problems or simple sketches. But during this video, we will study about bit difficult projections of the solids. So up till now, we have studied two-stage problems as well as three-stage problems, in which we have already discussed that first stage drawing is important by locating whether it is resting on base or resting on corner, and then we will go on producing for projection related to HP and projections related to VP, or inclination related to HP and inclination related to VP, whether the object is resting on VP or HP. Depending upon that, we went on drawing the two stage problem as well as three stage problems. Now in this problem, if you observe, a hexagonal base prism with base side 18 mm and axis height 30 mm rests on one of its bottom edges on HP, such that its axis is tilted to HP by 30 degrees and tilted to VP by 45 degrees. Complete its projections. Now if you read first line, that is, a hexagonal base prism is resting on HP. So it is clear from this that top view will be observed as a hexagon, whereas front view will be observed as a rectangle. Now another thing, it is clear here that the prism is resting on base edge. So base edge will be towards your right side, because we have practice of tilting the solid towards right side or in the clockwise direction. So when we are rotating or we are inclining the front view in the clockwise direction, we must rest the prism in such a way that the base edge will be towards your right hand side. So accordingly, we will draw the top view. So top view will be hexagon with the side, base side, parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. So if you observe here, we have drawn a hexagon here in such a way that this base edge and this base edge is perpendicular to VP, whereas parallel to HP. So it is named accordingly, A, B, C, D, E, F, and according to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay. Now project this base edge vertically upwards, project this base edge CB vertically upwards. The height is given as 32 mm and the base side is given 18 mm. So each of this side will be 80 mm, base side will be 18 mm, and when we project it upwards for the front view, height of this, that is height of the axis, will be 32 mm. So draw a hexagon of 18 mm side such that the base edges will be perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Project it upwards to get the front view of height 32 mm. So accordingly, we will name it. Now this is CB projected here, so it will be B'C'. This is D and A projected upwards, so it will be A'D'. And this is EF projected upwards, so it will be E'F'. So this is the base on which it is resting on HP. Now another face, that is top face, will be 3-2. So here it will be 2-3-1-4. This will be 1-4, and this is 5-6. And the axis, of course, will be overlapped by A1 or D4. Now we have completed the first stage, that is a rectangle as a front view and hexagon as a top view. Now as the rectangle is in the front view, we will be inclining this in such a way as given in the problem, that is, the axis is tilted to HP by 30 degrees. So we will make it inclination as 30 degrees with HP. So axis is along the line A1 or D4. So this axis will be making 30 degrees with HP. But while drawing this sketch, we must ensure that EF should not leave the base or xy. So it should be resting, EF should be resting on HP as it is given the problem, that is one of its base edge is resting on HP. So EF should not leave the xy line or leave the plane HP. So now as it is given that axis is making 30 degree, if you consider this as a right angle triangle, where this is the right angle here and this angle will be 30 degree as given in the problem. So this will be 60 degree. So better way, practically we will draw a 60 degree angle base edge or base face by keeping EF on the XY line or EF on the HP, make a 60 degree angle and redraw this cage here. So this total prism or front view of the prism with axis making 30 degree, will of course will be make base will be making 60 degree, we will redraw it. So after redrawing it, we have to project. Now we will project BC downwards like this. So this is BC, we have projected downwards. This is point B projected here, you will get a point B here. Then it is followed by C, so we will project C here, you will get BC here. Then it is AD point, so A will be projected downwards, A will be projected horizontally, so you will get A point. Similarly, you will get D point, that is projecting D horizontally, projecting D vertically. Then EF, similarly we will plot the point E and F. E is projected horizontally and vertically, F is also projected horizontally and vertically. So you will get A, B, C, D, E, F. It is the view of the base when the axis of the prism is making 30 degree with HP. Now about top face, so when we project 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this, so 2 and 3 is projected downwards, horizontally 2 will be projected, you will get point 2. Then 3 point is projected horizontally, 3 point will be projected vertically, you will get point 3, so it is a 2, 3 line. Then 1 will be projected horizontally, 1 will be projected vertically, you will get point 1. Similarly on the same line, you will get point 4 by projecting 4 horizontally and 4 vertically. And about 5, 6, so 5 dash and 6 dash will be projected downwards. 5 will be projected horizontally here and 6 will be projected horizontally, you will get 0.5 and 6. Now the question arises that which of the lines will be dotted line and which of the lines will be dark line. Now the observer is here now. The observer is observing vertically downwards from here to here. From the observer, EF is away from it. From the observer, EF is away. So the lines related to point E and F will be dotted line. So see, here we have point E. So point E is a common point, that is ED, EF and E5. These three lines must be dotted line, whereas F is here. So line FA, line F6 and line FE will be dotted lines. So in all, if you observe three lines of this and three lines related to F, total 5 lines will be there because EF is common. So these 5 lines must be dotted line. So while drawing, we will join AB, BC, CD as dark lines, AF as dotted line, FE as dotted line and ED as dotted line. Similarly here, as this face is totally visible, so all the lines related to this face will be dark lines. So we will connect, join 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5 and 4, 6. Now as the external area or external lines will be dark lines, so we will connect 1A, 4D and this will be the hexagon. Now as AE, E6 and EF, AF, F6 and FE will be dotted lines, we will join those with dotted line. But as B2 is a dark line, see if you observe this is a B2 line, so B2 is a dark line. So B2 will be drawn as a dark line and then later on remaining part of F6, which is to be expected as a dotted line. So F2 will not be a dotted, but B2 when we join with dark line, it will be overlapping the dotted line. So remaining part of F6 will be dotted. Similarly here E2, E5 is expected to be a dark line, a dotted line, sorry. But E3, that is the part of C3, will be a dark line. So 3, 5 will be a dotted line. So if you observe this visibility of this, when you are observing from here, point EF is away from you. So the lines related to E and related to F will be dotted line. So accordingly, we have drawn it here. Up till here, it was similar to the video we studied priorly. Now, the next part is the axis is inclined to VP or tilted to VP by 45 degrees. So now, we have to rotate this, or we have to rotate in such a way that the axis of this will be at 45 degrees. But if you observe, here the axis is 32 mm. Later on, when the prism was inclined, or the axis was inclined at 30 degree to HP, this is shortened, or this line will not be a true length line. So O dash, which is axis of the prism, will be reduced by length. So this is apparent length. But when we are saying that axis is making 45 degree to VP, means the true length of the axis, or true length of the axis of the prism, will be making 45 degrees. So here we will initially draw a 45 degree line, which is expected to be a true length line. Mark the true length on this, draw a locus of this, and on that locus we will mark the apparent length or top view length of axis here. So it is OO dash, which is a true length of the axis line, that is 32 mm. OO dash is a locus, or locus of O dash or O1 dash, on which we will mark this as a top view length, and then we will redraw these things here such that again ABCD will be towards VP and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be away from the VP. So redrawing this by drawing these parallel lines, 1, 2, 3, 4 parallel lines parallel to the apparent axis we have drawn, and according to the, by marking with the compass the distances here, will complete the view. Similar view we will be copying here. So dotted line shown here will be dotted here is also. Now when we have completed this prism view, we are observing from here. So the line or the points away from we are A, B. So here when we project these things, that is A, B, C, D, we will project upwards, A, B, C, D we will project horizontally. The points related to B and A, which is away from the observer, will be dotted. So here again similar thing like here. So the lines related to A and B will be dotted lines, other lines we will complete as a dark line, and finally we will get the view of the prism when its axis is making 30 degree with HP and 45 degree to VP. So this part is new for you, where we are drawing a true length line at particular angle, and later on the apparent length of the axis, marking it on locus of the O and completing the view here, or rotating this total sketch at that particular angle and project it, we will get the final view. So for this I have referred Engineering Graphics by Mahalakshmi Publications House. Thank you.